Together with NASA, he's launched a plan to create housing that could support living conditions for people on the frigging moon. That's right. This is the coolest thing ever. We've got Jason Ballard, the co-founder of Icon and team leader of Project Olympus, dialed in to explain this amazing endeavor. What's up, Jason?
Hey, Kelly. Happy to be here today. Thanks for having me.
Oh, my God. I always love having a cowboy on. I like your hat. Before we talk about living on the moon, which is super cool, explain how you, like, 3D print houses. What?
Yeah, so Icon exists because we need more houses, we need better houses, and we need them more affordably. And so we start with digital architecture, and we use our robotics to layer by layer deposit our printable concrete until it forms a house. We're able to do this weeks faster than conventional construction. It uses a resilient material. We're able to do it more affordably, and it's creating all kinds of opportunities to help us solve the very real housing challenges we have here on Earth. We've printed about 24 homes in Texas and in Mexico that are permitted, that are occupied, and we're excited about what the future holds for this technology.
It's insane. What a cool job you have, and cool purpose. Well, tell us about the Project Olympus and your plan to build humanity's first home on the moon. That's awesome.
Very good. Yeah, so we've partnered with NASA and the Bjarke Ingels Group and others to design a construction-scale 3D printer for the moon, for the lunar surface, so that we can build humanity's first permanent home on another world. The idea is that we would take moon dust, what's called lunar regolith, and we would use lasers or microwaves or outright melting to deposit it in a very similar fashion that we do here on Earth, except to make a livable, habitable place on the moon. I've actually got a prototype here, here in the lab, that we used a desktop 3D printer to create. You can see it's like super elegant. This is made to help us live and exist in the very challenging environment of the moon, where there's radiation, temperature swings, these kinds of things. So this can be done. This can be 3D printed, and all we have to do this is on a much larger scale. And in fact, Kelly, I think I sent to your lab some of the simulated moon dust that we use to do some of our research here.
That's right. We have a lab, people. That's right. The Kelly Clarkson Show. Thank you, Justin. Wait, so this is moon dust?
That's simulated moon dust. So we took everything we learned about the moon from, like, the Apollo program. We can actually make simulated moon dust to make sure the technology we're developing will actually work on the moon surface. And in fact, I have some right here. So, like, we take that dust you have in your hands, and using lasers or microwaves, we can make, like, a buildable material just like this. And so this will be the construction material that we'll use on the moon. We won't have to bring everything with us. We can use what we find. This is actually stronger than Earth-based concrete. So I don't think this is, like, way hundreds of years in the future. I think we will have a moon base in your lifetime, Kelly. In fact, if you'd like a spot, I can put you in touch with some people.
Don't you lie to me, Jason. I want a spot on the moon. I just want to go. Thank you so much, Jason. I'm so honored to have you on our show. This is incredible. Your purpose is incredible.